Hello and welcome to a Homebrew Wednesday, which actually on a Wednesday. Wednesday, 12th of May, 2021. I thought I'd fire a quick video downstairs right now as we're talking, or as I'm talking and I'm videoing this. My vegan gesture is being caked under pressure, closed transfer, the whole shebang. With it being a homebrew Wednesday, I have a beer. I'm not going to tell you what it is. Not going to tell you anything about it. There will be a video about that beer coming up in due course. And I just wanted to basically keep the channel alive, keep it going. I often say, or often thought to myself, I'll never just put a video out unless I've actually something to say. So today's was basically just that I'm doing the close transfer. So I'm in a brewing mindset. Work has been an absolute ball bag. I've been working all our God's sand, so I haven't actually had a chance to do a brew day for over a month now. I was meant to do my Belgian Witbier. That's German. I don't know what Belgian people speak like. So I was meant to do that this week. Actually, I meant to do it yesterday. But then I got called into work, so I couldn't get a chance to do it. I had a brew day planned for last week. It didn't happen. So every time I plan a brew day, it doesn't happen. I like getting up early in the morning to do my brew days. Get them done, dusted, everything put away for lunch, and then have a big fry is generally how I do it. You've seen in a few videos I've done overnight mashes and things to try and speed that process up because I really like a big fry. Unfortunately, that hasn't been the case, so I think that a brew night may happen this weekend. Tomorrow is a no-go at work, then Liverpool play Man United. Then Friday, I have something planned that takes me away from the house and the brewery and what have you. So either Saturday or Sunday. But then I'm off all day Monday, and I'm definitely off all day Monday. So it could be Monday. But I'm going to do a Belgian wit, as I've said. So hopefully, I've had a run of not brilliant brew days, so I'm hoping that this will bring me back. Even though it's a style and a couple of processes that I've never done before, adding sort of fruits and things to different parts of the boil. Although I added fruit to my, controversially added fruit to a Kolsch last year. So yeah, that's basically where we're at with the brew day. I'm just going to pause you. Imagine I was a better video editor. I could have done that and you would never have known. But anywho, so that's you basically up to date with the brewery. I am actually going to use, I have used the gelatin in my vegan gesture clone. I'm not sure, do I actually have any footage of that? Is it going to be a video? Let's check, shall we? Just talk amongst yourselves there. Don't appear to, might have some on my phone. Anyway, I'm sort of not entertaining as much here. So the vegan gesture clone is going to be for the last day of the football season. I'm having a what is the rules at the minute? Up to 10 people from two different houses. I'm having one of them in my garden. So we're having a couple of lads round. And we're going to be drinking vegan gesture, basically. What else is new? Well, I've been watching your guys' videos. I obviously sent some videos or some beer out to a couple of people. Shout out to Dude's Brews, shout out to Big Banana, and shout out to Yorkshire Brew, Tony. I've actually really enjoyed watching you critique my beers. I think it's fair to say that the sour beers, whilst you guys seem to like them, I think the general consensus was that they weren't sour enough. Sorry about that, that's my WhatsApp coming through. And what else did I send you? You got two sours. What did you get? He's got two sours. I'm pretty sure you got four beers. The Rusty Pale, the Rye IPA. Guys seem to like that. It's one of my favorite beers that I've ate. One of my favorite commercial beers, the Rusty Bucket by Kinnegar. And it's one of my best beers that I've made, in my opinion, anyway. Last year I had a run of some fantastic beers before I actually had the balls to send them out. And then finally then you got the Stronghold, which was a milk coffee stout, which seemed to go down quite well also. So it's kind of weird. Stout's not really, stout or porter is not really a beer that I would drink very often, either commercially or I don't make. That's actually the first one I've ever made. But when you start out in the homebrew journey, a lot of people always recommend make a stout first because it's very forgiving. And I have to say, given that I'd had a run of bad beers or bad brew days, you know, the stout, in my mind, everybody that's drunk it seems to have enjoyed it. I dished 10 out to guys in work. I brought a six pack over to another fella who only drinks Guinness. I've obviously sent them four bottles out to you guys. And everybody seems to really, really like it. So that's quite, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, builds you up, makes you feel better about yourself. So it's a bit like that. So yeah, that's really it. Tony, the Yorkshire brewer, he put my stout on camera there yesterday, the day before. So he had that at age a wee bit longer than I had, and it certainly seemed to benefit from it. I then had one last night as well, off the back of watching it. And yeah, it's a different beast now. It's probably on the other side now of its peak. It's probably coming back down. So I'm going to finish them off in the next week or so. So yeah, looking forward then in the brewery. Obviously, I've said I want to do the Belgian wit, and then I have another one of my favourite styles is an Irish red, so I have the ingredients ready for it, and I'm chasing a bit more mouthfeel, so I'm going to up the maltodextrin. It was 500 grams last year. Was it 500 grams or 250 grams? If it was 250, it's going to be 500. If it was 500, it's probably going to be 750. I'm not going to go for a full kilo. I just want that slightly thick. I can't think of a commercial example of what I really want. You know, you have your likes of your Caffreys and Kilkenny that used to be commercially available, and they would be poured through nitro pumps, and that sort of would add a bit of volume, a bit of mouthfeel. But it's not that I'm really looking for. What I want is, it's kind of like a stout feel in the mouth, but with all the sticky, malty yumminess of an Irish red. So I'm gonna be fiddling about with that menu or that recipe over the next couple of days. I've converted the keg that the Vegan Gesture is going into this afternoon or this evening is the second keg that I've converted to from dip tube. Just with the gelatin going into it and just wanting it to be a really clear beer. It's just an extra tool in your arsenal for that, isn't it, really? I think that's really all I've got for you at the moment. that's all I've got for you at the moment, I think. Let's see, what have we talked about? Talked about shit brew day so far. We've talked about not being able to brew. We've talked about the Belgian wit and then the Irish red. I think then after the Irish red, we'll probably be in June then. Last year I brewed a lot of Kolsch. Last year I brewed maybe 5-6 brew days of Kolsch of various different types. Add a bit of fruit and this and that. Never really got very much traction. And then this year, every man, woman and child is brewing Kolsch, and I've missed the memo. Is it too late to brew one for me for maybe July and August time? I don't think so. I mean, I'll drink it on Christmas Day because I'm mad. But yeah, so Kolsch will probably be being done again, and I haven't done a good IPA in a while. Back to sort of my bread and butter. I really, really enjoyed last year when everybody done the Altogether IPA, so I might give that another rattle. And then I have a load of Sabro downstairs. Although I watched a video last night of someone making an Indian pale lager, which is basically an Indian pale ale but lagered or done with lager yeast, and they put Sabro in it. It is one of my favourite hops at the minute, so I might give that a whirl. But if you watched any of my previous videos, you'll know I don't really go into water chemistry and stuff like that, and I'm not really sure if I've got the tools to do a lager justice. We'll see. And then that leads me on to an issue that I addressed a couple of weeks back, in that I was approaching 50 subscribers, which has traditionally been a milestone that people might do a wee competition, a wee giveaway. And I said I wasn't going to do it because I had other ideas and when and different things I was going to do for a competition. But next month, being June, is also my actual real birthday month. So I am going to run a competition, a draw rather than a competition, let's be honest. And it will be open to anybody who subscribes to the video anybody who subscribes to the channel at all. And the closing date for subscriptions will be the end of June. So 30th of September, April, June. So on the 30th of June, I will do a video of drawing out the winner, perhaps. And you will get a mystery prize. Ooh. Yeah, so I'm almost finished my beer. I'm deliberately keeping it out of focus on the camera so that you don't know what it is. Stop looking at it, stop it! And I always finish a beer before I finish the video, so down the hatch. Happy Homebrew Wednesday, everybody. Sláinte.